Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Welcome back to our Taste of Learning, the third and the final segment of today's topic, Taste of Learning. How can we get it? Alhamdulillah, we've got a lot of tastes so far with the help of our honorable guest and also with the help of a parent and a student here. Alhamdulillah, now show today in the studio, there are two more guests on the right. Let me introduce Mahir Mubarak. Yeah. Mahir Mubarak is at year
8. I'm going to year 8. This
he
year.
Is going to year 8
this year.
This year, London East Academy. Yeah. London East Academy. And next to his sitting is his parent, his father. Mubarakullah, Muhammad Mubarakullah. Jazakumullah to come to our show today. Alhamdulillah, to give us some time. Inshallah, we will talk to you. So, we have reached to a point where we have derived some solutions to our problems. Why children are disinterested in learning? What are the reasons that children might play truant, bung off? Okay, and why and how a parent can help a child to get rid of this problem, to solve these kind of problems. Alhamdulillah, let's come to this on this segment on the point that we will go to our first of all to the guest, our teacher, Brother Musleh Faradi. Could you please tell us about the improvement of literacy and numeracy? As we can see that our children are suffering from literacy, you know, in terms of grammar, sentence structure, although they speak, you know, the native language, because native speakers, but in terms of writing, they really, really suffer. It doesn't match with their speaking sometimes, as I can see, when the subject verb doesn't agree. Could you please tell us, give us some lights on this point? How can a child improve on literacy and numeracy?
Again, this is a very vast area because first you need to identify who is the child you are talking about, what is his or her level, you know. If, say, we are talking about young children, then you have to follow the particular method. If they are the older, then their method will be different.
Could you please define young and older?
Well, if, say, for example, say, the beginning, beginners learning. I think the according to the research, that most learning takes place before the age of 5.
Okay.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So the main foundation of learning happens that age.
Before 5.
According to one, I remember reading, according to one philosopher, that 75% of basic learning takes place at the before the age of 5. Mm-hmm. Of a child, because that time what you do with the child, you know, that makes the foundation. And then, because I was originally trained as a primary teacher, mm-hmm. so we had to go through, you know, all those methods.
I think I can add something to your
okay,
point.
Okay, go on, please.
Because I did translate one article from Reader's Digest when I was back home in Bangladesh. In that article, I translated that when at the age of nearly 2 years old, a child develops billions of memory cells. Subhanallah, that are the catching points for a child to catch from the surroundings.
Okay.
Yes, please, go ahead.
And then most important thing parents can do that time is talking to their children, talking. You know, if you have some training, then this talk you can actually plan such a way that your child benefits a lot. You will find that some children, when they come to school, yeah, they use very high level of vocabulary.
Okay.
You know, where did they learn from? From their parents.
Okay.
So parents take this opportunity. When there is an opportunity comes, they use those words. in a context, because we never learn anything without a context. Every learning takes place in a context. Okay? For example, you can use vocabulary, you know, in everyday situation. Sometimes you can use mathematical terms, you can use scientific terms when the situation arises. See, it depends on obviously parents' educational background as well.
Okay.
So the talking is really important. Parents, how they talk with their kids, how they explain, how they answer questions. Sometimes when in our community, children ask, then we put them down and say, "Ah, don't ask too many questions."
Okay.
Actually, you should be really happy, pleased your child is asking question.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if they keep you asking question and you give them explanation, they keep asking you until they are satisfied. That's the best method of teaching.
Mm-hmm.
You see,
yeah.
Their language is developing. You know, their understanding is developing. Another thing you can do is play games with them. And for math teaching, game is really very, very good method.
For math,
there are different games available, mm-hmm. you know, for different levels. And parents, sometimes you can actually learn from them. You know, the games is also another method. So that's about, you know, the young kids. And then when they are slightly older, take them, involve them in everyday family activities. For example, go shopping.
Okay.
Let your child count the money and take the money from, nowadays obviously you pay by the card, but to for the benefit of teaching your children, just take some cash money,
mm-hmm.
you know, and then give them the opportunity to pay and take the change,
okay.
and then see
in real life situation.
Real life situation.
Mm-hmm.
To make learning informal.
Okay.
If you teach them in real life situation, they learn better.
Okay.
You know. Similarly, you talk about the literacy. Talk about your own history.
Mm-hmm.
You don't have to talk about talking even English. You talk. So talking and then the storytelling. You know, story reading is a great method.
Will provide an imaginative power.
Yes, yes. Story reading and create a, let your child have his, her own library at home.
Okay.
Give some money. This is really great. And
so
you
these,
show.
Sorry to interrupt you.
That's okay.
These are particularly for the older children.
Older children.
The first ones were for younger.
For the younger children.
Fantastic.
Such older children.
Yes.
Let them have their own library.
Yes.
And then also, you need to remember you are the most important teacher of your child.
Mm-hmm.
So you have to be a role model.
Okay.
You have to show your love for books. Your child need to see, oh, my father, my mother, they love books, you know. You automatically, it will encourage.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you read. You also writing. You
mm-hmm.
sometimes, you know, you show that, oh, I went somewhere,
mm-hmm.
I wrote, look, this report on that.
Okay.
And they show your child, you know, this is the report, what do you think about this?
Mm-hmm.
So, example, role model, is really important.
Mm-hmm.
It is possible for most parents, you know, to do.
That sounds really great. So, we will hear, like, love to hear from Mahir about these things. I think this should be a quite good example if we hear from Mahir. Mahir is here. Mahir, could you please tell in the first place, what were your levels in SATs?
In SATs, in spelling, punctuation, grammar, I got level 6. In
fantastic.
In maths, I got level 6.
Dear viewers, level 6 is the highest level. Perhaps you are aware of it. Yes, go ahead.
Maths, I got level 6. And in reading, I got level 6.
That's an excellent result. We must appreciate you. We are really happy that we have got a child like Mahi here. Alhamdulillah. So let us know about them, as your teacher has just said, that reading, in terms of reading, let's take reading.
Mm-hmm.
How could you improve, how could you advise the children who are viewing today's show to improve their reading, for example, vocabulary? Could you please tell us briefly?
Well, if you find an aspect of reading, or a genre that you like reading, then you can like aspire to better stuff. Once you read a part of or a subject that you like reading,
mm-hmm.
then it can make you interested in different stuff. and it can help you like have different different vocabulary when you annotate the book.
Annotation. Yes, go ahead.
So if you annotate the book or look at the vocabulary used in the book, then it can help you like write better, and it can help you speak to other people better as well.
Okay, so you have just said that which you have picked from his saying that annotating. How could you use these annotated words? For example, similes. For example, synonyms. Okay, you've got a word. You've picked a word, and you want to get more synonyms of that word. How could you use those words in your writing, in your work?
Well, you can use a thesaurus, which is basically a whole book of synonyms that can help you like get better words for like descriptive writing and persuasive writing as well.
Mm-hmm. Fantastic. That sounds really great. So, which type of writing you like most? For example, there are descriptive writing, imaginative writing, persuasive writing.
I like descriptive writing, like books with an historical element, like about the Holocaust, or something adventurous with something that actually happened. So you can think about it and relate to what's happening now, and that can help you write better stories and help you talk to other people once you know something about the subject. I can help you in school as well.
That should be fine. So what are the elements in descriptive writing? For example, adjectives. Go ahead.
Yeah, once you've like learned lots of adjectives and similes and metaphors, that can really, really, really help your writing, because it can help you like describe the way you speak into your writing.
That means you've got to be interested in finding more words, not only using the same words at all times. You have to make your work colorful in your writing, in particular, using those new words. Okay, let's move on to our parent today, Brother Mubarakullah. Could you please tell us briefly as to how did you help Mahir improve his vocabulary, improve his English, improve his other subjects, for example? Could you please tell us briefly?
Sometimes I help him as well. I buy some books for him. Mashallah. Sometimes I buy newspapers and bring home. Sometimes I want to read as well with him. Then he encourages.
Okay, that's like a good example. Yes.
Sometimes I take him to go to library. Sometimes I introduce some.
Could you please tell us about the newspaper? You just said, parents do normally buy books for their children. I've heard, but in terms of newspapers, tell us, how do you use that newspaper for your child?
Now, just I bring, for me. Then he, if I put, if I read and I leave in table or wherever, then he see, then he reads. Indirectly, I didn't buy for him, but I buy for me. Then he reads.
Okay.
He encourages this indirectly.
That sounds really good. Okay. Do you have any plan for your learning, daily, weekly, monthly? Do you maintain any plan for learning? Do you give some keep away some time for your learning?
Usually, once I've got a project to do, I keep it away so it doesn't have to be a big hassle. Just do it once. It's gonna take a lot of time. So usually, what I do is like weekly or daily. I do like half an hour or 1 hour. I dedicate to like reading, or dedicate to doing revision if there's a test coming up, or I dedicate it to like doing a project. So basically, 1 hour a day, at least 1 hour a day.
That's great. Okay, we have heard, we've learned a lot of things from our guest and from the parent and from the child here. So do call us on 0207-096-0405 and join with us with your views, with your comments. And also you can ask questions, seeking advice from our guest today in the studio. So, dear viewers, we can see that we have come to a point where we have revealed that there are some problems, and the problems were the language barrier, and this language barrier is definitely not the sole reason for a child not to be improving or to get distracted from learning. There are more reasons, and parents can place, although parent doesn't need to be that much educated, they're not much good at English or good at any other subject, but still the parent can help a child by providing support, by motivating a child, by buying books, even by buying newspapers. A parent is buying newspaper for himself. You can see the guest is here. So, and the child is taking advantage, is benefiting from the newspaper by picking words, new words. And in their books, when you are reading a book, you have to annotate those things. So come forward with your views, with your comments, and ask questions to our guest. Now I would like to go to our guest again once again. Could you please tell us, Brother Muslim Faradi, already you have covered some activities in terms of how a young child can be supported by their parents, and how an old child like my hero Tanjim previously could be supported and motivated by their parents. Could you please tell us, are there any activities from school or from library or from society, from elsewhere, where they can benefit from for the improvement of their learning?
As we said before, that children actually learn informally more than maybe from formal learning. And if a child is interested in doing something, then you let him or her, you know, pursue that. Is really important. To start with, if you have any hobby, for example yourself, you pursue that, okay, but don't impose on your child. For example, say you love to read fiction. Yeah? So your child actually, he sees you are reading, you are spending your time, you are dedicated, you know, dedicated for it. Mm-hmm. So he may not actually be interested in fiction. He may read something else. Yeah, maybe he'll be reading all the most children do is what is it, sports. Yeah, they read a lot about sports. But then let him actually read, because he's interested in sports. But when he reads in English, he is developing his vocabulary, you know, and he is engaged in it. Sometimes we think that, you know, only a very high academic book, if they read, they learn. No. They have, as I said before, they have to be interested first. You know, that's really, really important. Also, in our daily activities, we can actually incorporate some other things. For example, rather than you writing note for shopping, you know, shopping notes,
a list,
let your child do it, okay? And if child makes mistake, you know, in spelling, let him or her correct it.
This can be applicable to older children also, because there are some words coming, vocabulary coming, which are really difficult to spell in terms of some, you know, products.
And also, as I said before, you know, when you go shopping, ask your child to read ingredients. Ask your child to read, you know, other things, whichever, for example, is it healthy food or not healthy food, all those things, you know.
Some argumentative issues can be argumentative, for example,
And then, if you go on a holiday, for example, take them, take some pictures, you know, and they come home, let's do a display on our holiday. They love it, you know, writing about the pictures, you know, we went on holiday in so and so place and we enjoyed this and this and that. These things can be done. So you have to do this, you know, like in a informal way, you know, and obviously when they become used to, when they become interested, when they know actually this is the way they have to progress, they'll take their own initiative. So you have to wait for them, for that time to come when your child will be taking initiative for his or her own learning, rather than you impose. And as I said before, this lot of encouragement is really important. And also, as I said before, talking. See, children, they are watching a television, for example. You can't stop them from watching television. Am I right? Mm. Do you watch?
Sometimes.
Okay. So they will watch. Now, you need to talk about, ask them, what did you watch today? Yeah? ask them to, what are the characters?
Share with you.
Share with you. Which character do you like most? Why do you like this character, particular character?
So you have to pick up the positive things from
things. And you have to first, maybe to start with, you say, oh, I watched this kind of show and I like this. Set an example. Yeah. And then they will be encouraged to talk about. So it's just not something they are just idly watching. They are actually then thinking, the next time my father or mother will ask me, I watched a program, then what it is, you know. So this, I mean, make, you know, the talking point for and matter of discussion. And then there, if you think carefully, you can actually bring many things in your discussion.
Okay.
You know, possible.
There are a lot of good points came, actually. So, for example, a child can write a diary after coming back from holiday. Okay? So, could you please quickly, because we're going to wind up our show today, tell us very briefly, how could you advise to the viewers today, your friends and family and some others viewing today's show, how could you tell them?
Well, I would like to say that everyone should value every subject like the same. They shouldn't think that this is more important than that, because at the end of the day, one subject could be as important as the other. So, because some people, like I've seen in my friends, that they think, oh, I don't need to learn science because I'm not going to be a scientist. I don't need to learn English because I'm not going to be being a writer, stuff like that. So that's why they should like think that every subject is the same. Also, that I would like to say that sometimes some people, they value stuff more and think that sports is more important than learning, and they dedicate more time to
other
sports.
Stuff than other stuff. Learning.
That's not needed. Not needed.
Not the worst thing, actually. Yeah.
So that they should value education, and they should show some interest in it rather than just spending time in sports and games and stuff like that.
Okay. This sounds really good, actually. It's a matter of patience. We have very little time. Let's very quickly, could you please tell in a few seconds, how could a child benefit from their parents?
Yeah, parents has a lot of, you know, influence above the children.
Mm-hmm.
If, you know, parents' behavior, parents, everything affects on child.
Mm-hmm.
That's why, you know, we have to be careful. We have to be our talking, our behavior, our everything. How we are sitting, how we are, talking, how we are playing. They are learning from us.
So our attitude is very important. Let's very briefly, because the time is, they are notifying me over and over again. Tell us very briefly to the parents, to the viewers, how could they improve? In one word, please.
Well, let your child pursue his or her own interest.
Jazakallah. So this is the main thing we have picked from today's show, that let the child pick their own interests, pick their own options, and let them take their own lead, and that will help, inshallah. My dear respected viewers, brothers and sisters, wherever you are sitting and watching this show, and the children who are watching this show, please take these points on board and take them, please, seriously. We will, inshallah, move on to our more episodes coming on the next Saturday. Every Saturday there will be shows, like I said before, just to remind you, every Saturday from 6 till 7:30 p.m. we will run this show. Stay tune in at 6 o'clock, inshallah. Come forward with your views, comments, and ask questions. No more for today. Jazakumullah for attending us, for coming to the show today, to share your views and contribute. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.